Setting up high-speed inputs and calculating the rate can be intimidating, but with CLICK, it becomes just another simple function. This video shows how to set up an encoder to high-speed inputs on a CLICK PLC for rate calculation. To use high-speed inputs on CLICK, you must have a CLICK CPU that supports Ethernet and has DC inputs. High-speed counting is not supported on units with AC inputs. You must have CLICK programming software version 2.30 or higher, and update the firmware to match this software version. I have an MPN open collector quadrature encoder that meets the voltage requirements of the CLICK PLC. Wire the A pulse into X1, the B pulse into X2, and since this is an MPN encoder, I will place the positive 24 volts DC to the C1 common of the CLICK CPU. To start the setup, select the function tab, select here on the high speed input setup. Now this display really makes the difference here. It shows you exactly what each function does. All you need to do is check the graphic and then select the button that says use this mode. We are calculating rate, so select here on frequency measurement. First, I'm going to give this function a name. Select here to assign where the rate will be stored. I'm going to use DD1. Now this is a signed double integer, so the range will be. Now I'm going to select here and select the type as quadrature. Now we need to assign the inputs for this function. So select here. And since we're doing AB, you can see these are in pairs. So I'm going to select X1 and X2 and then hit OK. This portion will allow you to put a multiplier on the count. Now for rate, you have two options. You have either Hertz or RPM. Hertz is just a function of the amount of pulses per second, whereas RPM is specific to your application. So once I select RPM, you'll notice that I'm asked to enter a number. Now I'm looking specifically for the rotations on the encoder itself. My encoder has 360 pulses per rotation. Press OK. Now you'll see your rate function assigned here. Press OK. And now you'll see all the registers that are assigned to this function here. So load the project into the CPU. Open a data view, add my rate register, and spin the encoder. If you see a negative rate here, that just means the process is running in the reverse direction. If you need to change this, just flip the A and B inputs on the CLICK CPU. So no more intimidation when it comes to encoders and high-speed inputs. Just another way CLICK makes advanced simple. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment below or call in to our award-winning technical support team. Click here to see more CLICK videos, and select here to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see our new products and solutions.